In a previous video, we covered Autopark and how to use it, how it works, and how performant it can be, which was not very, as you can see by the length of the video and how many tries it took, and by the comments. Today, we take a look at one of our first interactions with Vision Autopark. Not the very first, because I had to learn how to use it and learn that the thing actually existed on our car. Next couple videos, we'll be looking at if we get an opportunity for a parallel park situation, we'll do a video on that. And then if there are any major updates to performance or anything like that, we will make a video on that. And then if and when we get Elon's promised smart auto park or reverse summon, we'll make a video on that and we'll catch you on the flip side. Let's take a look. All right, Casey Loon here again today. So sometimes our car will offer to Vision Autopark on FSD Beta 10.8, the holiday update. So let's reverse and see right there. There's no cars over here. Show them, Luna. There's no cars for us to key off of. Over here. Yeah. So then come back here and we're going to hit start. And it's going to do all right. It's not going back 8 spaces to find a parking space like it would have done in the past. It is using the lines to do this. Now my camera's dirty, so it may not succeed, but it has succeeded in the past, which is why I decided to record this. So yeah, I didn't like the ice or something, I guess. So let's try one more before Mona has to run her errand. Let's try over here near these cars and snow. Let me just put it in reverse. I don't have any P's showing up or anything. I just put it in reverse and it's gonna try. So what's been happening in the past is I've been lining it up as if I was going to park. It would flash red because it was going to try it on its own, and then I never told it yes or no. So it's going to park next to this car this time. And it's still just as scary as it ever has been. Because basically all I did was take the craziness and turn it into visual. And now we've got somebody trying to come through. It's going to be interesting because people will be impatient. Okay, so it didn't work at all this time. We'll try one more. Hopefully we'll go to the other side of the parking lot where there's not people trying to race through in their Mopar machines. And maybe I'll clean the camera. I'll be right back. We just had a pretty good snow, so that's why the camera's dirty. And why the car's having trouble seeing. Alright, so let's try another one. It's not like, oh, I don't keep my car clean. But literally, you drive and the whole back of the car just sucks all the dirt up, so that's what we got. All right, so let's try again. All right, so we've driven past some spots. Let's put it in reverse. Nothing. All right, so let's go somewhere else. Here we got some snow drifts, car on jack stands, and a bunch of empty spaces. So let's do reverse. I don't think it knows which one I want. All right, so we'll pick one. We'll start towards it. Put it in reverse. Okay, so now that it knows where I'm trying to go, we'll hit start, and hopefully we'll complete this time. I don't know how you're gonna do that. All right. The good thing here is there's no cars next to us, so I don't have to feel nervous like I did last time. And nobody's coming to run us through to get through this shopping center, so even better. Excuse me. So you see, it's using completely the lines, but the software is treating the lines like it used to treat cars. So it's still the multi-shift and still slow as heck, but when it works perfectly, just like the other one. And so the next step, I think, is that they're gonna have to combine this with summon for, what did Elon call it? Everybody else likes to call it reverse summon, which is inaccurate, because summon in reverse is very easy. We've had that since AP1. Elon calls it smart auto park, I think he called it. So that's all for today, and we'll catch you on the flip side.